Hello friends, let's take an overview of different type of career options available for people with expertise in derivatives. So what are the different types of career options? What are the qualifications and skills required for you to get into those careers? And who employs people with expertise in derivatives? Let's look at each of these. As we know, BFSI or Banking, Financial Services and Insurance is one of the biggest employer of graduate and postgraduates across the world. Well-paying jobs are available with different kind of skills requirement. There is a good career progression and also good income potential for you. Derivative markets and products are growing very fast. They're expected to grow fast in the future as well. These products are by nature complex, and then therefore the differentiator being a knowledge of derivative products is very much a reality. The career options exist across the entire value chain in derivatives. For example, starting right from sales and trading, strategy, research, the analytics or analyst kind of options available in, let's say, data analytics, information technology, also options in risk management, compliance, in operations, and then the operations themselves, you know, the derivatives trading, reconciliation, clearing and settlement. So across the entire value chain, there are a lot of career options that come up, and these are good career options in core finance. Sales and trading jobs, for example, typically they involve designing different kind of trading strategies, you know, understanding the products, the market, the movements, right? And then creating trading strategies to sell to the clients, you know, what they should do in the derivatives market, acquire new clients and help manage their profit and loss, you know, because you want to make sure that the clients don't end up making too much losses in case the trades don't go through, which is of course a possibility, right? So you need to manage their P&L very, very well. And then of course, relationship management is very important in the sales and trading jobs. The other kind of job is the research analyst jobs, where you analyze data and trends from the market data, for example, the price movements, the open interest, the volumes, and so on and so forth. And then you create and execute strategies based on that. You also find the opportunities for arbitrage. If you know, if you can do some kind of trades where you can exploit the market price differences, you know, you are very much rewarded by your employer for doing that. And you can use, if you understand well, you know, option Greeks to sort of look at how you can manage the trades better so as to make higher profit. There are, for those people with more of, you know, IT sort of mind bend, more of logic, mathematics kind of capabilities, programming capabilities, there are data analytics kind of jobs, right? So you look at the data, you analyze the data, make sure that the data has the right integrity, you know, take out the data that doesn't make sense, right? Do performance reporting for the clients, for the traders, you know, for specific desk and so on and so forth. And also to help perform the reconciliation and implement the management controls. For example, how much positions should be there, you know, how much of collateral should be taken, so on and so forth. Right? So these are data analytics jobs. Then strategy jobs, right? So fundamentally designing any kind of strategy, building a strategy, right, for a particular trade desk. So for example, the fixed income derivatives trade desk or currency trade desk, let's say USD trade desk in a bank, right? So build strategies for them, you know, what kind of trades they can do and how they can manage the risk. Develop different kind of pricing models. For example, if you are writing options or a futures contract for a customer, you know, how much should you charge as a premium, right? So develop those kind of models. Develop trading tools to monitor the risk, for example, the price fluctuations, etc. Create a portfolio of different trades and how, you know, the trade has to be funded. For example, what kind of collateral is acceptable, are the G-Secs, currencies, and so on and so forth. Then analyze the performance of a portfolio and also optimize the performance. You know, try to see that the losses are minimum and the profits are maximum. So this is basically a job of a strategist in derivatives. There are risk management jobs where you build risk models. For example, you know, how do you exactly calculate the risk in derivatives, and at different points in time, depending on what is happening in the market, the risk can change. You have to, you know, manage the entire process of risk. You have to leverage the data because, you know, you are continuously getting data from the market. So continuously you have to run the analytics based on the latest data available. Monitor the trends in the market, look at the volatility. For example, is the market volatility increasing or decreasing? Monitor the P&L positions of the desk, of the traders, of the clients, and, you know, what kind of positions are there, what is the open interest in particular kind of, you know, options or futures, and then decide on, you know, closing or netting off and so on and so forth. These are the typical risk management kind of profiles. the compliance profiles which, you know, help the investment bank, you know, traders comply with the requirements. So the requirements around KYC, know your customers, anti-money laundering to see that, you know, the customer funds are tracked, and if any suspicious transaction is there, it is reported to the regulators, and, you know, you talk to the customer and get the requisite clarifications from them. The anti-bribery requirements, for example, you have to identify people with, let's say, the politically interested persons, right? So those kind of requirements are there. Then due diligence requirements around, you know, creating the products, taking the sign-offs, monitoring the risk and compliance requirements, right? Investigating specific cases, marking, taking them to closure, ensuring customer data privacy requirements, you know, monitoring, investigation, all those things. These are key part of compliance in the derivatives. In the operations side itself, if you are an ops analyst, you know, then you can be involved in various stages of the derivatives product cycle. You could be, you know, once the trade is done, for example, it might come to you for the confirmations, for reconciliation, clearing, and through the settlement. For example, the transaction processing jobs are there, right? So transaction processing and reconciliation is very important in derivatives transaction, because these are by nature complex products. So, you know, it might require you to specifically confirm some trades with the counterparty. The settlement and clearing has to happen properly. You need to be continuously, you know, in touch with the exchanges and clearing houses. You have to monitor collateral, whether the requisite collateral is available in the client account or not. Then you have to monitor the valuations, how the valuation of the trade is changing. And you have to also be, you know, doing the customer or the client service, right? Because you're dealing with the clients, any kind of operations issues, you know, you have to take care that the client is happy. And also you have to invoice the client for all the trades that you have done, right? So these are typically the operation specific jobs and derivatives. So the kind of skills that are broadly required for all these job profiles. Now I'll summarize this. Subsequently, I'll have a detailed video for each of these job profiles. You know, what is required to be done in that job profile, what are the skills required, qualifications required, and so on and so forth. But right now, overall, if you want to do a job in derivatives, you should have knowledge of derivatives, of course, right? Which you can get through watching this series of videos that I'm putting up. Risk management, because derivatives are by nature designed to be risk management instruments. You should have analytical thinking. You should pay attention to detail. You should have numerical abilities, right? If you want to be in finance, you should be good with numbers. You should have passion for numbers. If you have product management skills, you can become a strategist, for example. You have technical skills, you can become an analyst in derivatives. And in general, you require good communication skills, right? Because dealing with customers, dealing with counterparties, you know, they require good communication skills. And in BFSI sector, in general, it's being more professionalized, you know, the communication skills expectation is slightly higher as compared to other sectors. Now, who employs people with derivatives knowledge and skills? For example, banks, right? So banks do research on various products. They deal in the products. For example, banks typically, you know, do interest rate swaps. They do foreign currency derivative transactions. So they, you know, they need people for that. Then investment banks and brokerages, they do selling of those products to the various corporates, institutions. So sales and trading jobs are there, research jobs are there. They do a lot of product engineering, for example, create different kind of structured products specific to the customer requirement. And they do a lot of data analytics using, you know, a lot of sort of data available in the market, like interest rate movements, currency movements, right? GDP data, and so on and so forth. And they try to predict, you know, what kind of strategies can be designed. Asset managers and hedge funds, of course, those who, you know, sort of buy and hold, or hedge funds which want to take higher risk. There are jobs available in research, there are jobs available in strategy and design, there are jobs available in risk management, and, you know, so on and so forth. So additional employers include, for example, insurance companies, because insurance companies also, you know, for example, IRDA has guidelines for how insurance companies can use IRS or interest rate swaps, right? So they also need, you know, derivatives expertise to handle those kind of risks. Exchanges, clearing houses are there, you know, the once the trading and, you know, matching and confirmation is done, then it goes to the clearing houses. So, you know, trading, risk management, technology, those kind of jobs also need derivatives knowledge. Regulators themselves need people with derivatives knowledge. There are technology companies that produce products, you know, for example, for trading, for, you know, the risk management, for compliance, analytics. They need people with derivatives knowledge. And then we have back offices of large investment banks and banks in India, right? For example, in Pune, Bangalore, NCR, and all these cities, where they need people to, you know, settle the derivatives trade, reconcile the derivatives trade, and so on and so forth. So these are the kind of, you know, employers that are employing the people with knowledge of derivatives. Now, knowing what I have been telling you will help you differentiate yourself, you know, as compared to others. You'll be able to develop a niche expertise in derivative and identify good roles and opportunities for you in the derivatives, thus ensuring that you have better career prospects. please wait for some time. I'll be producing a separate set of videos explaining each of these, you know, sales and trading and analytics, etc., job profiles in more detail. So I hope you found this video useful. If you did like this, then please share this with your friends and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. Take care. Cheers.